Here we're going to have a go at animating an object so that it actually follows along a path. We're going to do this two ways. First way we're going to do is going to use a utility and apply that to a very simple animation that we're going to apply to a car. And then we're going to create a path, and using that path we'll get the car to drive along and follow it, which is a preferable way of doing things. But we'll have a look at both ways just so that you can see exactly how you're doing it. So first thing we need, obviously, is a car. So go into the top viewport, maximise this viewport, and create our car here. Convert this to an editable poly, and let's just give this a very, very approximate rough car shape. Extrude this slightly. Have a nice big spoiler. Super streamlined. There's our car ready for Le Mans. Right, go to our top viewport. So we've got our very, very basic car, and now I'm going to apply a very simple animation to it. So I'm going to turn on the auto key, move to frame 20. If you're not familiar with this, then maybe you could have a look at the introduction to animation video that I did previously. Just animate this car around. I'll click this, you can see our car whizzing along. You notice it's not rotating at all, it's just moving and it's always pointing to the right. So let's have a go at applying our utility. And the utility, where we have to create, modify, and so on. Utilities is the icon at the end, which is the hammer. We click on Armor and we click on Follow Bank. Okay, that. I did click on that. Let's try that again. Follow Bank, there we go. And then we apply our follow. You see a whole host of keys have been created for us. If I click on Play, you can see that the car is now rotating to follow. Now that's one way of doing this, nice and quick and easy, but I'm going to use a different way. And to do this, I'm just going to highlight all of these keys and delete them. We don't need these. And pop our car back up in the top left hand corner. Alright, for this we need to create a shape. And we're going to apply a path constraint to this. So if I create a circle, very nice simple circle, and click on our motion, open up the motion panel, select our car and find the controllers, there we go, and where we have position, and select the position, and I'm going to assign a controller to replace this current controller. We're looking for path constraint, so I'll select that, click on OK, and now we just need to tell it which path to follow. So with the car still selected, click on add path, and then you just move your cursor over the path that you want to use. When I click on this, you can see the car immediately pops to the path that we're going to use, which is this circle. Click on add path just to deselect this, and if I click on play, you can see that there's two keyframes that have been created automatically. These are created by default so that you can see your animation. If I stop this and check the follow, you can see my car now is following along. Now I'm going to change this to the perspective viewport and zoom extent so we can see it. You can see our car here is now following along on our circle. All right, nice and easy. Now you might find that your car doesn't follow in the right direction, maybe it's going backwards, and in that case you'd have to click on flip, or you might need a Y or a Z, so it'd be down to the individual object that you're using, how you created it. Mine, the way it's been created, it's already in line to go in the right direction, but it all depends on the object that you're working with. So let's change this path slightly, because going around in a circle is a bit boring. I'm going to convert this circle to an editable spline and click on the vertex, and let's start moving some of these vertices around, maybe changing some of the handles, give it some tilt. I fancy refining the spline as well, putting a couple of extra vertices on there. There we go. And let's watch our car whizzing along this. Now we have our other areas that we can click on. So if I click on a car, so maybe I could choose it to get it to bank, so that the car will tilt slightly as it goes along the path. You don't just have to use the default keyframes either. You can actually delete these, which I'll do now, and we can create our own keyframes. So if I auto key now and move to, say, frame 20, I can have the car move along the path. That's 20% along the path. And then maybe at frame 30, go a bit quicker down the hill. Frame 40, reach the hill, and have it take a little bit longer to get to the top of the hill. To the bottom, just as it's coming back up again. Up to the top of the hill. And then back to 100%. So let's just play that animation. Didn't spend too long, but you get the idea of how you can control how the car's going to work. You might find that when you get to this point, you want the car to go backwards. And I've actually gone backwards to 54% on this last keyframe, so we can watch this one take place. Gets to the end, and it's gone backwards again. So that's as easy as that. The path that you use, you don't necessarily have to use the circle. You might want to create your own path. So if I delete that path and zoom out, and I'll delete that path from there, click on my car again, delete all these keyframes, and I'm going to draw a path. I'll do it in the top viewport. I'm going to create a line and clicking and dragging. We can have it following a nice circuit. 100 frames probably isn't enough. There we go, there's our nice path. If I around and move some of these down a bit. I'm not going to worry too much about moving the handles around. And you can see we've now got a path with a few extra turns in it. Get back on our car, go back to our motion panel, click on add path and select our path again. I'm going to need to set this from 0%, go to last frame, 100%, and this sets up the keyframes again. Let's have a look, and there goes our car. Again, you can have a lot of fun playing around with this and changing the path to suit your needs, and you can have it going over the contours of a hill or around a track. So if you made a Scalextrics track, you could use the path that you've created for the Scalextrics track and just apply this path constraint and have it follow it that way, which is quite handy.